Hi everyone, how is everyone doing? I really hope that this day is going greatly for all of us. In the morning, I did a story about, you know, how has this Monday started for all of us. And many of you actually, you know, responded that it's going positively and nicely. And few of them really responded to that overwhelmed option. And I believe that not all of you have done it very, you know, unknowingly. Because I understand that most of the time, you know, the weekend, when weekend ends, week starts with a lot of work, and you know, in no time a lot of stress comes in, and we are just, our mental space is just all over the place, right? So I really wanted to talk about on this thing today, because I have talked about stress in my videos once in a while, but never talked about you know, very kind of tips and solution to just manage stress, not getting rid of it, because getting rid of stress is not possible with the kind of lifestyle we have, with the kind of, you know, multitasks we carry. So anyways, you know, I believe since this lockdown happened, the coronavirus and the next lockdown, and you know, again and again, so many lockdowns and stuff, when it happens, that has actually caused many reasons to just letting that stress come in. Because you know, the basic reason I want to tell you behind this is that our body basically loves to be in kind of a routine. And before lockdown, we all had a very, you know, strict, you can say, kind of a routine, because if we are working people, then we had a 9-to-6 job to go for, and then come back and then cook our meals, and then just spend some time with our family, and then just doze off to the bed and just get ready for another day. So that's how things went, you know, especially for working people. And it was kind of similar for students going to school or colleges, right? So you know, the basic two reasons which I can see that has caused reasons of stress in our daily life, first of all, is that getting out of our, you know, routine. So you know, whenever the rhythm gets disturbed, the kind of routine or rhythm our body loves to be in, when it gets disturbed, having stress is very, very normal. Because our body loves to have meals at very particular time each and every day. Our body loves to sleep at a very particular time each and every day. Similarly, our monthly cycles, they like to be very particular with the dates, if the body is very, you know, performing healthy, in the healthy way. So routine is something which our body loves. And because ekdam se, you know, my life shift hui, so everything just got shifted, and we just, you know, were clueless like how to set in this routine. So basically, the biggest one of the reasons is that, you know, our body forgot the routine. And the another reason can be our stagnant life, because when we were at work or college or school, you know, no wonder we were always walking around. Even to just grab our lunch, we will just go to the canteen and have it with our friends. So we are automatically, you know, moving in the active mode. But when, since we are locked at home and we are working from our computers, PCs, so 24 hours we are just sitting. And you know, our body loves movement. That's what I always say. Our body, to stay balanced, to keep our hormones on the place, it loves to move, and that has now lagged. And that is another reason which keeps our body stressed, our brains stressed. And another, it is just another reason that we are always stressed every now and then. So I will just talk about few, you know, tips which can really help us to manage our stress on a very daily basis. So anyways, first thing that has really helped me personally is, you know, setting myself a schedule. Make sure to, you know, always have a kind of rough idea in your mind whenever you're starting the day. Now it is very, you know, depending on your personal decision, like whenever you really want to do it. Some people like to do it before dozing off to the bed, and some people like to do it in the early morning after waking up. So it is, you know, time doesn't matter, but at least you should have an idea that what am I going to do in the next coming day, so that, you know, your brain is mentally prepared that what is going to happen and what am I supposed to do, rather than, you know, just ideally sitting and wondering about different thoughts and stuff. It can lead to stress, right? So make sure that you are always carrying a kind of a note in your phone or in your notebook, just that you know that what are those small tasks you have to do and what are the goals you need to achieve today, so that you are very, you know, sane and you have things to do. So you're not just thinking about the work, about the unnecessary things which should really not bother. Anyways, also this boils down to building that routine, because when you have a kind of a to-do list or a timetable or a schedule in your hand, you know that at what time I'm going to grab my lunch or what time I'm going to have a nap. So these things will actually keep you consistent with your lifestyle, and that's how you will, you know, keep your body into routine. And that is what your mind and body loves to have, and that can keep you stress free. So and if you're someone who just, you know, haven't worked with a routine at all, and you don't know how to be in routine, and you are kind of a spontaneous person, so first of all, you know, being spontaneous can actually lead to stress a lot of times, because I am someone like that. Being very spontaneous can really sometimes lead to stressful situation, because our body and mind is not very much prepared. And at least the things which are really in our control, like how my day goes, it is in my control, at least when I am having work from home, right? So you can just build a routine, and the basic step, the beginner step you can take towards building a routine is setting a correct sleep cycle and a waking up cycle. Not correct, a consistent. No matter at what time you are sleeping, but at least try to be consistent with it. Like if you are sleeping at 11 p.m. in the night, try to just, you know, hit the bed at the time, because that's how your body knows that you are falling into a routine. And trust me, this simple change can have, you know, giant kind of good effects on your health, and really can help you to just avoid stress. The second most beautiful tip is breathing. Now, I'm not talking about meditation and stuff, nothing fancy. We are just going to focus on breathing, the way we breathe. We just have to take at least 5 minutes in the morning, or 5 minutes in the evening, or in total 5 minutes. But I mean, how much time you have, just take out for just sit and do nothing, just breathe, and very, very mindfully to see what is the movement going while you're breathing. Like when you are inhaling, you should feel that you're inhaling, your diaphragm is going down, your, you know, stomach is just coming outside, and when you're exhaling, your stomach is again squeezing in. So you should feel that movement, you should know about it, because this will actually make you mindful and let your body take a lot of oxygen in. Because most of the time we are so busy in our day that we are mostly doing shallow breathing, and we don't even provide good amount of oxygen to the body, which can, you know, again lead to many inflammatory conditions, and can just make us prone to diseases. So anyways, make sure that you are keeping your body oxygenated by taking deep and nice breaths. Also, you know, when we actually exhale, our body hits the parasympathetic state, which is kind of a rest and digest state, where our body knows that everything is okay, we are in relaxed mode, everything is fine, nothing to be stressed about, and this really helps to just, you know, be stress free every now and then. And it's just like you have to breathe. And if you are very, very, you know, beginner, you can just go for, there are many kind of apps and YouTube videos for that. You can just go and see, there are so many breathing techniques, so you can just hop on for that, or we can just make another video for this. But yes, breathing is a beautiful practice to just manage our stress. Now the third and the most, you know, my most favorite point, that is cut off violent and toxic things and people and situations. Try to cut them off completely, because sometimes we know that the friends we are living with, the relatives we are living with, they are toxic, but we are like, okay, it's okay, I don't care, it doesn't bother to me. But you know, kahin na kahin, it sets in your subconscious mind, and it shows up in your small tasks and your small behaviors. So I just mean that you need to try to cut them off and just keep them, you know, as far away as possible if you can, because that can actually, you know, just make your energies, your make you vibrate at a better frequency, and you know, just fill you with positivity, which can really help you to just be you know, away from negativity and any kind of stress. So try to surround yourself with people who can actually, you know, provide you with some positivity, or are actually calm and positive in most of the times. So that can really, you know, have a good effect on you. And also one tip I really want to share in this, related to this, is, you know, when you are actually always complaining that, oh god, I have so many toxic people around, my life is just, you know, about crying, and people are so violent, so negative around me, then it won't work very nicely and it won't unfold very nicely for you. But if you will just start focusing on yourself rather than others, and if you will start to be positive and be, you know, full of life and just about happiness, then automatically with time you will attract such kind of people, such kind of energies in your life. So rather than complaining about others, just, you know, if you don't like them, if you know that this is toxic, cut them off, focus on yourself so that you can, you know, attract what you deserve in your life. Another beautiful tip that boils down to movement, because as I said, that stagnant life is, you know, causing a lot of stress already. So movement is something which you need to inculcate in your lifestyle. Again, I have talked about it so much in so many videos. You can just go and see. Anyways, for movement you don't have to always do a lot of workout and stuff. Don't have to sweat it out. Walking is the most beautiful form of movement. You just have to walk. Yes, walking is much better than running and jogging, especially when it comes to stress, because running and jogging are excellent, but again, they are putting some kind of stress on our body and we don't want it, right? Walking is most beautiful for that, because it is not going to cause any kind of stress. Instead, it is giving you good movement, gentle movement, which is responsible to, you know, just get those endorphins in, which can really make you stress-free instantaneously. Movement can be very, very bio-individual. You have to just move the way you want to move. You don't have to just copy someone else or see what others are doing. If you like walking, walk. If you don't like walking, stop it. If you like to clean your house, clean it. It is kind of a movement, right? If you like to dance, dance it out. If you like aerobics, Zumba, stretching, yoga, whatever you like to do, just do. Make sure that you are taking at least 30 minutes out in a day to just move your body and just, you know, twist your body a bit and or just take a walk, whatever it is, but make sure to move. Moving on to our fifth tip, that is start questioning yourself and talking to yourself. Whenever you are feeling a bit stressed and anxious, just don't yell on someone and don't just blame someone and don't be about negativity and stress. Rather, sit with yourself, question yourself that why am I actually feeling this? And when you acknowledge that feeling, see where and why is it causing you so much of pain. Then see what is that thing or who is that person or whatever it is that is responsible for the same, and see that is it really in my control. If it is not, then let's just, you know, let it go and let's move on, because that's not in our control and we can't do anything about it. So why to think so much, and let it go and let, you know, your body and mind take some time to cope up with it and, you know, just depart from each other. And another thing, if you can really have control over it and you know that you can do something about it, then why to worry? We will do something about it tomorrow and it will be okay, and just let it go. So these kind of thoughts can really help you to just avoid any kind of negativity, which can again lead to so much of stress and again can attract some people like that, attract some situations like that. So we don't want that, right? That is your last point, and again a very beautiful point, is you know, anxiety and stress and too much irritation and stuff can be a symptom of, you know, suffering physical health, because it can be due to food allergies, or the food you're eating is not suiting you, or you're eating crap, or you're eating wrong food, or you are, you know, just your hormones are all over the place. So these can be the reasons, and as I always say that you have to always look after your root cause. So for hormonal balance and stuff, I have done another videos, you can go and watch them, that what you can do to balance them naturally. Anyways, the point is you need to start taking care of your physical self, because we all know that how much our physical self and our mental self is connected, right? Because the food we eat really affects our overall gut health, and we all know that our gut is our second brain. So our mood can be very, very, you know, dependent and connected with the food we are having, the gut health we are having. So basically we have to take care of that thing also. And when you actually feel physically great, automatically you will feel mentally great, and that works very vice versa, right? So anyways, I think these tips will definitely help you if you really start to inculcate these things in your lifestyle and you know start implementing them. And yeah, that's it. I really hope that you all find it useful. Let me know if you really want me to talk on different topics. Till then, you all take care. I love you. Bye bye.